Hello friends, good morning. First of all, I welcome you all to the very first online class of mine. Let me introduce myself Rajkumar Pandey, and I am supposed to teach you English. Rather, I would say I am supposed to help you to learn English, because at this particular stage, at 11th and 12th standard, we take it for granted that you have learned the language. And the main objective of this particular session, this particular years, we can say 11th and 12th, to help you to use that language for communication. So for that will be the objective before us. Friends, generally, the students of 11th and 12th standard, I don't call them students, I call them career builders. Now, you are career builders. You are going to build up your career. So you will have to be very serious, because you are going to choose the direction of your life. You are going to choose the career of your life. So you must be careful while taking any major decision. You must consult your parents or your teachers and take each and every decision with deep care. That is very important. The book that has been framed for you people is nicely framed. Various units are given there. Four sections are there, and we will be dealing with almost all the things that have been prescribed for us. Now, in this particular year, due to this coronavirus, almost first session has been completely affected. But students, it doesn't matter. We have to work hard and make up the lost things. Now, in that way, I would say that your responsibility has been increased. You will have to work harder than the earlier students, because your session has been affected by coronavirus, not theirs. So be responsible, be serious, be careful. Isn't it? That is very important. You are going to build your careers, so you must be determined. You must be dedicated. And one more thing I would like to say in the introduction, that you must have your own planning and you should execute it. Friends, your parents are definitely expecting something better from good from you. So you must try to fulfill their dreams. It is your responsibility, isn't it? My best wishes are always with you. So after this short introduction, let us begin with our real work. Today, I have decided to discuss very first poem from our second section, which is a poetry section. Now, so far as poetry is concerned, I always tell my students that while studying poetry, in fact, poetry is the most interesting part of literature, because when you read some particular prose article, prose lesson, you will enjoy it. But if you read the same prose article for the second time, you may not enjoy it as you have enjoyed it earlier. But that is not with poetry. If you read a poem for the first time, you will definitely enjoy it if you read it seriously. If you read it for the second time, you will enjoy it more than the earlier time. Because in poetry, very compact thoughts are there. Thoughts are expressed with the help of limited words. And that's why generally it is said that while reading poetry or while studying poetry, reading words and understanding their meanings is not important, is not sufficient. You must be able to read in between the lines, because there are hidden meanings, and you must try to get what exactly the poet wants to convey. Poetry is nothing but just a thought that has been raised in the mind of the poet, and he is trying to convey the thought to you people. Most of the times, while conveying our thoughts, we can say, words may not help, but suggestions are there, and you must try to learn these suggestions. You must try to get those suggestions, and that's why reading in between the line is important for studying poetry. If you read the poem again and again, you will enjoy it more and more. So let us begin with the first poem. The title I have written on the board. Cherry Tree is the title, and the poem is composed by the poet Ruskin Bond. who is famous for his short stories, essays, poetry. He has published so many books, and his books or his stories, we can say, always carry some message, and that's why his books are very popular amongst youngsters, young children, we can say. So we are very fortunate in that way that we have got the poem of the great poet written great poet Ruskin Bond, and we are going to see the poem, what exactly is there in that poem. To make the ideas clear, to make you a particular view to look at the poem or look at the text, I have written some main points or important points here on the board. These points will help you to understand the subject of the matter, subject matter of the poem. See, the first point here, the main objective of the poem, that is struggle against adverse conditions. Now it is important, I told you that you people are career builders. You are on the journey of your career, and while trying to build, while establishing your career, you may face many adversities. So you should be prepared to face almost all sort of adversities and achieve your goal. That is the message, that is the main objective of this poem. Struggle against adverse conditions. He has tried to explain his point with the help of an example from the nature. Nature teaches us a lot. We should learn things from nature and improve ourselves, our personalities, our performance, isn't it? So, struggle against adverse conditions. In this particular poem, cherry tree. In fact, cherry is a small fruit. Usually reddish, sometimes black also. Cherry tree, he has, in this poem, our poet has given the example of cherry tree and tried to convey this particular thing, that we must be ever, I have written here message also, we will talk about it in later. For fighting against adverse conditions, we must be determined. We must be adamant on our determination, on our aim. So, while reading the poem, you will find that poet has expressed his proud feelings for planting his own tree. He says that he has the particular joy, ecstasy, we can say, extreme joy over creating a life. You know, see how nice. If you plant a seed, we are not only planting a seed or we are not growing a tree, we are creating a life in this nature. And poet gets that happiness that he has created a life in the form of a cherry tree. And that's why I have written here, the poem is about ecstasy over creating a life. Ecstasy means atyuchcha ananda, atyuchcha ananda jala apanu, ekhada life create karnyacha ananda hi ya poem madhe aplyala pahayla mel. Then there is, what is there in this poem? Journey from planting to a blossom tree. He plants a tree, and what happened throughout the journey of life of that tree, we can say, he has penned in this particular poem. I have tried to consolidate the message of the poem in few words. Here I have written message. What is that message? See, then we will read the poem. One must learn to fight against all negatives or all adversities. We must learn it, and we can learn it from nature. That is what poet says. One must learn to fight against all negatives in the onward journey of life. We are on the onward journey of our lives. We are supposed to face adversities. We must learn to fight adversities. Whatever adverse condition we face, we must be prepared to, we must be ready to accept the challenge and face it. In the onward journey of life, to be a winner at last. If we are prepared, if we are determined to face any adversity, then definitely we would be the winner at last in life. So everybody wants to live a happy life. Everybody wants to be winner in his life. So for that purpose, these are the conditions. And he has tried to express all these things with the help of an example of a cherry tree. So poem written by cherry tree. Now before we go to the poem, I would like to tell you some examples. I would like to put before you some names. I have written here some names. First name is Mark English, second name is David Hartman, and third name is Graham Bell. Know these personalities? Now, Mark English was a double amputee. Double amputee means whose both the legs have been amputated for medical reasons. He had a dream to climb Mount Everest and became the first double amputee to climb Mount Everest. He did not give up his dream, though he was affected, though his legs were amputated. He was adamant on his dream and he continued to work hard. He faced so many adversities and finally became the first double amputee to climb Mount Everest. I have written another name here, David Hartman. David Hartman is a name who is known to the world as the first blind doctor. He was blind. He couldn't see. Both of his eyes were useless for him. But he wanted to be a doctor. Now, for being a doctor, we can say eyes are very important to observe the patients, to diagnose the patient. But without eyes, he could diagnose patients correctly, perfectly, just by asking certain questions to him, and he became a famous doctor in the world. First blind doctor, David Hartman. Third name is Graham Bell. I hope you know this name. The man who had invented telephones. Do you know one important thing? Graham Bell invented telephones, but he could never use telephone. Why? Because he and his family, all the members from his family, his wife, both were deaf and dumb. But he invented that great thing, telephone, and that we people are using nowadays frequently. So what is common in all these three people? All these three people had problems. They had some disabilities, and only with the through their determination and hard work, they have overcome their disabilities, their drawbacks, and finally became winner in life. All these three names are world famous names. But Mark English, double amputee; David Hartman, blind; Graham Bell, deaf and dumb. Now, as compared to these people, we people are in very good conditions. So we must be very positive about our thinking. But our aim should be fixed. We must fix our aim and start working in that direction and prepare ourselves to face any challenge, to face any adversity that comes in life. So this is all about the poem in short. I hope you might have got the subject matter, the central idea of the poem. Now let us go through the poem and try to understand how our poet Ruskin Bond has expressed all these things in words, we can say. I told you, words are not much important. The thought behind the word is important for us. And it will be my suggestion to you people that you must try to get that thought which is there hidden in the words. Okay, let's see the poem, Cherry Tree. Friends, while watching this video, you must have your textbooks with you. Putting your textbook before you, then you will be able to understand it properly. So this is the first poem from second section, Cherry Tree. Now see how he has described his thoughts. In fact, the poem begins with memories. Generally in films we use the particular term flashback, something from the past. Here the poem begins in a sort of flashback, and in the next stanza or in the concluding part of the poem, the poet comes back to his present times. So what he talks about his memories that we are going to read in the beginning, in the first few lines of the poem. He says, 8 years have passed since I placed my cherry seed in the grass. He had planted a tree. He had planted a cherry tree, we can say, in the grass. And to that particular, for that incident, we can say 8 years have passed. Means 8 years back, he had planted a tree. Must have a tree of my own, I said, and watered it once and went to bed and forgot the cherries have a way of growing, though no one's caring very much or knowing. Now see what it happened. Generally, we all do these things. We plant a tree and then we forget it. He planted a cherry tree, watered it once, and then he had forgotten about it. But the nature had its own ability, we can say, to survive. Without proper caring, without paying any attention, we can say, the cherry tree struggled to grow. That is what he wants to point out here in this particular stanza. So, must have, why he planted tree? A thought came in his mind that I must have my own tree. And so he planted a tree. He wanted to create a life in this nature, we can say. So he planted a tree, but unfortunately forgotten about it. But tree struggled hard to survive. And it survived also. What happens? See, in the next time. And suddenly that summer near the end of May, some time lapsed. He's talking about the things that have happened 8 years back. So I said that he is talking about his memories first and then he comes to the present time. He says, and suddenly that summer near the end of May, I found a tree had come to stay. I found a tree had come to stay. Means I found a tree that survived, that came up the ground, come to stay. The blossoms have grown. It was very small, 5 months child, lost in the tall grass running wild. See the use of words of the poet. See his affections toward the tree. He is calling it 5 years child. So it's a small plant, small cherry plant, we can say. He says, it was a small 5 months child, lost in the tall grass running wild. Along with the tree, grass also was growing. And it was lost in the grass, but poet pointed it out and found that his cherry tree is alive. Goats ate the leaves. Now see, I told you that the adversities that the cherry tree faced. Goats ate the leaves while grazing. Many a times, goats ate its leaves. The grass cutters split it apart. Sometimes the grass cutter, while cutting with scythe, we can say, cut it, chop it, cut it apart, split it apart, and monsoon blight shriveled the slender stem, and it got affected by heavy rains also. So, 1, 2, 3 adversities are there. Goats ate leaves, grass cutter cut it, then heavy rains destroyed its leaves. But in spite of all these things, even so, he says, what happened? Next spring, I watched 3 new shoots grow. The tree is not ready to give up. Adversities are there. But it continued its work, its hard work, we can say, to survive. And he says, next year, what happened again? Poet could see 3 new shoots. 3 branches or 3 leaves, 3 birds, we can say, of leaves, he could see. Next spring, I watched 3 new shoots grow. The young tree struggled upward, thrust its arms in a fresh, fierce lust. The young tree, it's young, 5 or 8 months, we can say. The young tree struggled upward, thrust its desire to grow up, we can say, trying to push itself upward. Its arm in a fresh, fierce lust. Means it was so eager. It was spreading its arms. Means spreading leaves. Spreading its arms in fierce lust. Fierce means aggressive. It was very aggressive to survive. Not ready to give up. Ready to face any type of adversity. But want to survive. And that is the thing we must keep in mind. Whatever may come before us, we must fight against it and continue our journey towards our destination, towards our aim, towards our goal. That is the thing we can learn from this cherry tree. So very inspiring, very motivating kind of theme we have got in this particular poem. So what he says next? For light and air and sun, it was struggling hard, it was struggling fiercely for light and fresh air. I could only wait as one. No, in those days, poet says, I could do nothing. I could only wait. I could only wait as one who watched wandering while time and the rain. Well, time and the rain means while seasons come and go, I was just waiting for the tree, for the cherry tree that I wanted. Who watched wondering while time and the rain made a miracle from green growing pain. He says, I could do nothing but wait. I was waiting. Time passed, seasons passed, and finally I could see miracle. That tree, which was neglected, we can say, survived on its own and started growing. So I could see miracle. He says, miracle from green. It was a sort of miracle for him. This was thing of happiness, giving happiness to him. And then what happened? See, now these are the first few days after planting, first few months after planting the tree. But he could see that the tree survived somehow. But what happened then? He says, I went away next year. He talked about the first year, and then he says, next year I went away. I went away next year, spent a season in Kashmir. He spent some time, some period in Kashmir, spent a season in Kashmir, came back thinner, rather poor, but richer by a cherry tree at my door. He went to Kashmir for his work, we can say. He lived there for some time, but the climate over there did not suit him, and so his health deteriorated. He says, I grew thinner and rather poor. As his health deteriorated, his financial status also deteriorated. He was a bit poor at that time. His income was reduced. And in that condition, he came back from Kashmir. His health is not good. His financial condition was not good. When he came back his home, what happened? See, came back thinner, rather poor, but richer by a cherry tree at my door. He was not that happy. But when he came back and he saw a grown-up cherry tree in his door, he started feeling rich. He said, though I was poor, though my health was not good, I was feeling very happy and rich when I saw my own tree standing in front of my door. See his feeling. I have used here word ecstasy, and that is the feeling. Highest joy he was experiencing when he saw his tree, that it is still alive. He had planted it, forgotten it, but that tree survived. Then he had to leave it and go to Kashmir. And after coming up, after a long time, we can say, he was not expecting. But when he saw that tree, he became very happy. His own tree, his own life, his own creation, we can say. He had created a life on the earth. 6 feet high, my own dark cherry. It was grown 6 feet high now. 6 feet high, my own 6 feet high, my own dark cherry, and I could scarcely believe it a berry. And it was a 60.